So good morning all students. In today class we will take the terminology of the chapter first. In last classes I had to explain about the chapter first, asexual reproduction, vegetative propagation and terminology and then process. At the end of chapter, as per NCERT and as per RBSE, following terms present. So we will take the following terms. The first term, very common term, which is fertilization and then syngamy. Fertilization and second term, which is as we know about the difference of fertilization and then syngamy. In syngamy, only the following process takes place. That means the first cell, male gamete, and then second cell, which is female gamete, and the pronuclei of these gamete fuse and then produce the zygote, which contain diploid number of chromosome. That time the condition is called syngamy. Only the fusion of pronuclei is called syngamy. Clear? Now fertilization, all the events during the time of fusion of gamete, that means approach of male and female gamete, transfer of male and female gamete, then the capacitation and then fusion. So following events which are present in fertilization and then the last event, which is syngamy, only the fusion of male and female pronuclei. So it is a common term, which is fertilization and syngamy. So you can understand, as per your competitive purpose like NEET and other exam, that difference between syngamy and fertilization. Most of time it asks in objective questions that what is the difference between fertilization and syngamy. Only one difference, syngamy only one step, but fertilization more than one step. More than one step, that time the difference between fertilization and syngamy. Now, a next topic, which is types of fertilization. Types of fertilization, which is two types. First is external and second is internal. On the basis of position of fusion of male and female gamete, it is two type, external and then internal. External means outside the parental body, that time it is called external fertilization. And second, which is internal fertilization, means inside parental body or reproductive organs, that time it is called internal fertilization. External means outside the body, and then internal means inside the body in reproductive organs. So it is two types of fertilization, external and then internal fertilization. Clear? Now it is about fertilization and then types and then syngamy. It is a two different terms I completed. Next is, which is syngamy. The definition I already explained, the fusion of pronuclei is called syngamy. So it is of two types. First, based on source of gamete. Based on source of gametes, that time it is called two types. First is endogamy and second is called exogamy. So endogamy and then exogamy. Endogamy means the fusion of gamete fusion of gametes of same parents means the gamete which generally present in a bisexual animals, hermaphrodite animals or monoecious animal. Three terms are present in which is following: bisexual, hermaphrodite and monoecious. Before we start the explanation of endogamy, we will discuss about the bisexual. That means the organism in which the both reproductive organ present in a single body. That means a single body contain the testes and ovary in case of animal, and then in case of plant, the both anther, that means stamen, and then carpel present. So that time it is called bisexual organism. Second term used for the specially animal, which is hermaphrodite, means the both reproductive organs like testes and ovary present in a same body or single body. That time it is called hermaphrodite. And monoecious terms means the single body. In case of animal, single body contain both reproductive organ, and the single thallus contain male part of flower and then female part of flower. That time it is called monoecious. So three important term which will come in every part in the sexual reproduction in angiosperm plant. Clear? So bisexual means both reproductive organ, male and female in single body. Or the hermaphrodite means the animal which possesses the testes and ovary in the single body. And monoecious means the single body possess the male part and then female reproductive part. That means male reproductive part and then female reproductive part. That time it is called monoecious. So it is the exact definition. And then the definition of self-fertilization means the process by which the male gamete release from the one part of body and then transfer to the other part of body. That time it is called self-fertilization. And the basic or main term is called endogamy. Again we back on the endogamy. Endogamy means the fusion of gametes of same parent. Means the same parent or the single parent which possesses the male reproductive organ and then female reproductive organ release male gamete and then female gamete, and both gamete fuse in the single body. That time it is called endogamy. The term is called endogamy. Clear? Second is exogamy. Exogamy means exact opposite. Here is a self-fertilization. Now in exogamy is a cross-fertilization. Clear? In which the two different parent, the gamete of two different parent fuse. That time it is called cross-fertilization. In case of exogamy, unisexual. In case of exogamy, which is we can say the dioecious. The following term generally used in the case of, so we can write here the cross fertilization and then unisexual. That means a single reproductive organ in single body. That means male reproductive organ present in a male and then female reproductive organ present in a female. That time it is called unisexual. And next term is called dioecious. Dioecious means, di means two body. The two body, that means two different body, a male reproductive organ in male body, female reproductive organ in female body. So it is a complicated term, but the mean or sense of the same for all terms. So cross-fertilization means a fertilization between two different parent. It is cross-fertilization. Unisexual means the single reproductive organ present in a single body. That time it is called unisexual. Male in a male body, female in a female body. Dioecious means the two different body for two different reproductive organ. That time it is called dioecious. So it is the entire definition of type of syngamy. So again repeat, syngamy, the fusion of pronuclei, syngamy. Clear? It is just a part of fertilization, not a complete fertilization. Next, types of syngamy. First type, on the basis of source of gamete. That means from where they obtain the gametes. So if they obtain the gametes in single parent, that time endogamy. From two different parent, that time it is called exogamy. Clear? So it is the first terms, first part or the first source of gametes. Now next, or the second source, second types of syngamy. So second type of syngamy. First time, was already explained, exo and endogamy. Second type, on the basis of structure of fusing gametes. That means fusing gametes means the gametes which are going to fuse. It is depend on type of structure. Clear? So first isogamy and then anisogamy. Isogamy means gametes are same structurally. Structurally they are same. That time the fusion of two gametes is called isogamy. Generally present in lower organism in the protozoans. Anisogamy. Anisogamy means the fusion of gamete of different types, like different structure, different morphology. That time the syngamy is called anisogamy, generally present in a higher animals and higher plants. So it is a two type of gamete on the basis of structure of fusing gametes, and first was on the basis of structure of type of parent. So it is a isogamy and then an isogamy. Clear? Next topic after the syngamy, which is parthenogenesis. Term is parthenogenesis. The term means the process of sexual reproduction. It is one process of sexual reproduction in which egg directly develop into the zygote without fertilization. That means fertilization absent or without fertilization. Clear? So the process by which, especially in sexual reproduction, in which the egg directly develop into the zygote, egg develop into the zygote and then zygote develop into the offspring without fusion of gamete, without fertilization, that time the term is called parthenogenesis. Clear? So it is about the parthenogenesis, and then it was the terminology which is related to the NCERT and then CBSE. Now, pre-fertilization events means gametogenesis. Clear? By which gamete form. If we discuss about the gametogenesis, which is pre-fertilization events, we can bifurcate the gametogenesis into first in an animal and second is a plant. Clear? So it will come in the next chapter. Fertilization means the fusion of gamete, and post-fertilization events means after fertilization, which is zygote formation. After zygote formation, which is which is embryogenesis. That means zygote develop into the embryo, and then embryo develop into the fetus and then child. And in case of plant, the zygote develop into the embryo, embryo develop into the seed, and then seed now further develop into the fruit. So it is a sequence in the post-fertilization event in sexual reproducing organism. Thank you for joining my talk.